Are any blacks on the committee for Chicago Olympic Committee besides Michael Jordan as a token?
Well, I'm not, to be honest, he
with the World Sports.
Let me finish. I went World Sports Chicago. And my job is to be, I'm the CEO of it, okay?
For you.
Right, and my job is to bring international events to the city of Chicago, especially amateur international events. Not just the Olympic Games, but other events after the Olympic Games and before the Olympic Games.
So what's your interest in the Olympic Games?
No, because obviously if I'm bringing international events to the Chicago, the Olympic Games is about the biggest one you can bring here.
Let me ask you something, Mike, right now.
Yeah, go ahead.
Cut straight to the chase.
Please.
The Olympics is in 9 years.
Uh-huh.
The indigenous people of Chicago won't be citizens of Chicago in 9 years.
Mm-hmm.
They are resegregating the city.
Mm-hmm.
There is what we call economic and urban cleansing of the city.
Right.
No matter how they like to paint a picture of it. So when you do bring that to Chicago, the young black children are not going to benefit from this.
Right.
They've been exported to get it here now, but they're not going to benefit from it in the future. You got to live here to be here. You know what I'm saying?
Right. So, Mr. Conley,
let me ask you something.
Uh-huh.
Your purpose today, right now. In talking with us,
my purpose that I had heard that I was
at the Hilton Hotel.
Yeah, I was at the I helped more about the Olympics itself and from an athlete's perspective, from a Chicagoan's perspective, and this and that. And then on my way over to Washington Park, I had heard that there's some people protesting some facets of something. I had no idea what it was, and I've talked to some other community leaders before. And,
In Chicago about the Olympics?
Oh, yeah. The
Which
aldermans.
Community? No, they're not.
I'm the aldermans, press, the Chicago Defender, and this and that. And so, which I thought would have a pulse of the community. But, there was another lady that I met at the fundraiser. She handed me a list of some, I don't know, I'm not sure what it was. It was a hodgepodge of not even going to say issues, because it said based on what they think is coming here to Washington Park, but never really got a chance to hear any specific.
Was that a Miss Butler?
She was an African American lady.
Cecilia Butler. Yes.
That may be who. That's Cecilia Butler. Correct. Yeah, that's exactly.
Oh,
what,
she's
her
sitting
name.
In that truck over
yes,
there.
She is, like, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Can you just table this for a minute? This is the deputy, police deputy, and we do want to finish talking to you.
Sure.
What authority are you acting on in regards to this?
The World Sports Council, he actually has a liaison, a buffer.
I'm not a buffer. I just wanted to hear the concerns.
Is there going to be future contact? Are you that concerned?
That's what I'm talking
now,
about.
Now, today, let me ask you today, what can you facilitate? We're in contact with the Olympic Committee.
Okay.
We've been in contact with the Olympic Committee. They have a packet. We've been in contact with them since October. John Carlos has been acting on our behalf, okay? And so we're sorry that you haven't been involved in that conversation, being a Chicagoan and a former Olympian, because it appears that you're really out of the loop with the community's concern. Not your fault. Mm-hmm. Now that you know, then you have a responsibility to stay in touch with us.
We have.
But today, are you talking with Bob and them today?
Yeah, I'm here. I mean, I'm
okay.
I'm
now, well, I'm talking about, are you here speaking with them? Are you able to facilitate any kind of discussion with them and us today?
Today?
Yeah.
Today's not the day for it.
Well, no, we told
today
them.
Today's the day for propaganda.
No, all we want to do is have an introduction today.
Listen.
Can we have an introduction today?
I can't. I don't have that authority to say.
What better place does the Olympic Committee
What I want to do is that I'm going to be very sensitive to the community of Southside Chicago. I grew up here. All right, and if there's concerns and things that we can do that will enhance this community,
we'll have that conversation
but
later.
We
on.
Had we yeah. Olympics in 2016, and we and
not to cut you off, we got a meeting here. Thank you. Okay. Stay in touch with us.
Yeah,
sure. Okay.
Let's,
okay. Let's go, y'all. Let's go.
Look, if what better place?
Hey, real simple. Why are you guys out here today?
We're here for several reasons. One is that. Our organization has been in contact with the U.S. Olympic Committee and the International Olympic Committee since October 2006. We contacted them to express our concern about Chicago hosting the Olympics. Secondly, we're here because of the proposal to put the Olympic Stadium in Washington Park. But our group primarily is dealing with the fact that Chicago, based on the philosophy of the Olympics, the humanitarianism, and some other criteria that the Olympics stand for,
because of the Burge situation never being resolved with the torturing of 200 black men, that Chicago really is not prepared to host an event as vast as the Olympics that really is founded on the basis of humanitarianism.
Now, I know you guys would love to have gotten your voice heard by the Olympic Committee that's visiting here. It seems at this point that they bypassed this. They heard that you guys were out here and it bypassed this. What's your reaction to that?
Well, if they heard that we were out here and they heard what the delegation comprised of, I don't think that they would have bypassed it. So I would submit that the city propagandized the group and gave it a negative light to discourage the Olympic Committee. But we've also contacted them and told them we are willing to come to Colorado to meet with them. We are in touch with Mr. Ubaroff, who is the president of the U.S. Olympic Committee. We have various former Olympians who are working with us to assist us in this matter. I think it would just be in the best interest of everyone if the mayor decided to resolve the situation, put Chicago in the proper light. We're not the enemy. The Chicago just is not deserving of what the Olympics stands for. It's not an economic engine. It's an event that embraces the efforts of athletes and brings the community together. That's not what Chicago is doing at this point.
So I just want to make sure I understand you guys right. You're not opposed to the Olympics on its face. You're opposed to the way that what's going on in the city right now, from your perspective, isn't ready for the Olympics.
This city is not. I am a former contender in 1968. I made the Olympic trials in 1968. I am for the Olympics. But Chicago does not represent the type of venue that a proud heritage of the Olympics stands for. And until this city has made a decision to resolve the situation with this police department, with them upholding the torture of John Burge and not resolving that, Chicago is not prepared to have the Olympics in the city. And we stand by that.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
We get a look at that the Olympics were held in places like China and different places like that. I mean, which are wrought with things that wouldn't be considered part of the Olympic dream. So
I didn't understand the question.
Like China won an Olympic bid.
Okay.
So I mean, they're a lot worse than Chicago when
China says that.
Who says so?
We live here.
I'm talking about human rights violations in China.
The UN Committee on Human Rights has called Chicago the torture capital of the United States. And it puts it in the same category as Guantanamo Bay and Abu Ghraib. They didn't do that in China. And it's because of the law enforcement system of Chicago that the people have trusted that have tortured these individuals. So for the UN to say that, I think that has a lot more meaning than anyone else to say that here. We don't have that authority. We don't have that information. So we're more or less just reinforcing what the United Nations has said about Chicago.
We got wrong.
They are going to
the John Burge. That's a good message.
That's good.
It's good.
That's real good.
Yeah.
But what?
Who did John Burge?
That's right.
What they just telling us they blew it off.
They blew it off.
They decided not to stop.
Yeah, we got the call. Okay. We get the call when you get the call.
Yeah, we do that.
No, they just didn't stop here.
They come on our turf. I don't go on their turf.
All right, y'all have a good one. I just wanted to come back and touch base with you because we're all right.
Thanks, bro. All right.
All right. All right. My pleasure. Y'all have a good one.
Thank you.
And you're going to put jail in jail.
So give me a summation.
Summation was that it's a victory for the people.
Jail, okay.
The mayor did not have the guts to meet the people where the people are. And he has unfortunately propagandized, misinformed the Olympic Committee, further demonstrating that Chicago does not deserve to have the Olympics in this city because of him. He is the greatest impediment that we have to the Olympics.
It's a wrap. Get Pakistan, get Greece.
I wish I could keep this feeling. I wish I could keep this feeling. On the corners, niggas robbing, killing, dying just to make a living.
The corner was our magic, our music, our politics. Fires raised as tribal dances and war cries broke out on different corners. Power to the people. Black power. Black is beautiful.
like church services. Murderers, they ride serving burgers. It's cats with gold permanents. Move they bags, it's herbalist. The dirt isn't just fertilist. People working and earning. It's the curb getter. Show where the cash flow and the current is. It's so hot that niggas burn to live. The furnace is where the money move in the determined live. We talk shit, play lotto and buy German beers. It's so